Hello students, in the last session we have studied about the terms, factors, coefficient and variables. And now in this session we are going to study some types of expressions depends upon the numbers of terms. Okay, and these terms are same or not, that means these are like or unlike terms, and about the addition and subtraction of expression. So without wasting our time, we will start to study today's session. Okay, you can see this on this board. I have already written here monomial, binomial and trinomial. Okay, which these words are? Monomial, binomial and trinomial. These are the types of expressions. Okay, then how we can classify the expressions on the basis of monomial, binomial and trinomial? Okay, these are very easy. We can classify the terms on the basis of their numbers. Okay, that expression contains one term, two terms or three terms or more than three or one terms. Okay, so when we can say that the given expression is monomial when it contains only one term. So I will write here, contains about binomial, we contain two terms. About trinomial, they are contain three terms. Okay, already in the last session we have studied that how we have to count the terms. Okay, so you can see this here. I have wrote here some examples of expressions. Okay, while going through this expressions we have to count here the number of terms, and the basis of their numbers of terms we will classify that they are monomial, binomial or trinomial. Okay, so you can see this, my first expression is 4x squared. You can see this, in this expression there is no any mathematical operation like addition or subtraction. Okay, so that means it contains only one term, so this is classified into monomial. Okay, so I will write here monomial. A plus B, if there is a one mathematical expression, mathematical operation, that is an addition, that means it contains how many terms? Two terms. So I am going to write here, yes, correct. When expression contains two terms, it is known as a binomial. So it is a binomial. So I will write here binomial. Okay. Now the next is 2x plus 3y minus 5. Okay, so how many terms are there? 1, 2 and 3. So it is a trinomial. Very good. So I will write here trinomial. The next is x squared y plus xy squared plus y squared. polynomial. So I will write here polynomial. So with the help of number of terms, you can classify that expression in the monomial, binomial, trinomial, and polynomial. Okay, is it easy? Okay, so we will recall this. If any expression contain only one term, it is known as monomial. If they contain two terms, then binomial. If it contain three terms, it is known as trinomial. And if it contain many terms, then it is a polynomial. Is it easy? Okay, very good. Now we will move forward for the like and unlike terms. You know that like and unlike, okay, it is not favorite and unfavorite, okay, it is not like type of mean that. Like and unlike, here we will take same and different. Okay, like means same and unlike means it is a different. So what we have to find out the same and different, that it can be classified into like and unlike terms. Look at here, I have written here some expressions and you can see that all the expressions are monomial. 7x, 14x, negative 13x, 7 bar, 7x bar, negative 9 bar square, 5x square, negative 5yx, negative 9x square. You can see that there can all the expressions contain only one term. So all the expressions are monomial. Very good. And now we have to classify this all the monomials into like and unlike terms. So how we have classified that? Okay, instead of classifying, we have to find out the like terms. So other will be unlike. Very good. So how we can find out the like terms? Okay, you can see this. In this expression, look at the first expression 7x. We know that 7 is a coefficient and x is a variable. So we will find out the like terms with the help of their alphabets. Okay, number can be different, but if they contain same alphabets, okay, then these terms are like terms. Okay, so we have to find out the now like terms. You can see this 7x, it contains x. So which terms are contained with x? You can see this 14x, negative 13x. These expressions are also under x, but it also contains y. We want only x variable in that expression. So it is not a like terms related to these terms. Okay, you can see this 5x square. It is also contains x, but it is in the form of square, x square. And here are the only x. So it is not a like term in, according to these terms. Again, negative 5yx, there is an x, but it also contains 1. So it is not in a group of like term. And it contains x square. But we want only x. So what is the group of like terms that we have already find out here? Which contain x? So the first group of like term
negative 5yx are the group of like terms. So
times y square. Now the 5x square. There is a one more term which containing x square. So these two terms are containing same group of like term. So the third group of like term is 5x square and gave you 9x square. Okay. So as like that from the given group we can easily find out the like terms. Okay. So what we have to remind that by finding the like terms we have to concentrate on the alphabets, which is also known as a variables. Okay, which expression containing same alphabets, these expressions are like terms and others are unlike terms. If I gave the question as like that, 7y and we gave you 9y square is like term. Yes or no? The answer is no. It is a is an unlike term. Why is an unlike term? Because it contains y, it contains y square. Alphabets are same, but the index are different. It carries only one and it having here two. So these are the unlike terms. Okay. So with the help of this information, we have to solve many sums in given exercise. But before that, one more important point is there that we have to study, that is addition and subtraction. Okay. So without wasting our time, we will start to study how we can solve or how we can solve the questions depends upon the addition and subtraction of expressions.